Hey guys, welcome to the vlog. Today is Saturday. Emma and I are going to a farm that produces maple syrup and maple sugar products, and we are going to eat a lot of pancakes and play with some farm animals and eat some more pancakes.
Yeah. And are you excited?
I'm so excited for pancakes.
Pancake show.
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm not a big fan of pancakes.
Pancake show.
But I will try.
I'll eat yours.
Okay, you can eat all mine.
I'll eat all the pancakes. It's all you can eat.
And look out the window.
It's not really a beautiful day.
Yeah, but it's rainy. What are we doing now?
All right, so we came to a place called Stony Ridge Farms. It's a local farm, and they produce maple products, and they have other farmy type stuff. But today we're here for a pancake breakfast. They have a sugar shack over here.
Yeah.
So we're gonna see how they make it.
Inside.
There's gonna be tapping demos, and you're gonna be able to try to tap a tree yourself. See if you have what it takes. Let's go in and get some breakfast.
Alright, so we got a lot of sausage.
Wait!
Morning. Two adults.
Yeah, yep. I'm sorry, they're all single.
I love singles. You're all set.
All right, thanks a lot.
All right, so get you utensils.
All right.
Get you a plate. We got buttermilk. There's buttermilk and buckwheat.
Oh boy, fresh.
Thank you.
Morning.
Morning.
What's it got? Oh, sausage in there. You want sausages?
Yes, please.
All right, so you get three sausages.
Buttermilk and buckwheat. I don't know which one.
You're trying both.
Okay, I'll try both. Thank you. All right. Thank you.
And then you get your syrup, toppings. Butter.
Oh, I'll get syrup.
That's it.
Yep. This is the syrup.
And this syrup is made here?
Yes.
Okay. So this is
this year.
That'd be a cool trick.
Alright.
Ah.
Oh, it's Wegmans brand.
I'll get a drink.
And a cup of OJ. Alright, you good?
Yes.
Find a place to sit. There's two chairs right over there. Head on and grab them. Somebody sitting here? Alright, thank you. I've only had the buttermilk so far.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I like them both.
I didn't try the buckwheat.
Oh.
That's next.
Okay. How many pancakes did you eat?
Once I eat all these, it'll be 10.
Oh my goodness.
Or no, seven.
Seven. I ate four. Look at my plate. All of them.
So we just finished up with breakfast. How many?
I ate five total.
Week.
13 and three sausages.
Really?
All right, give me another plate. Thanks a lot. It was really good.
So over there, they're teaching you how to actually tap. So they'll give you a chance to do it. But it looks like it's pretty full right now. So maybe instead, we'll head into the sugar house.
They're so cute. Look at it. Maple syrup.
From?
From here.
Stony Ridge?
Oh yeah, so
yeah,
cool.
Yeah, so that's a local store.
Look at this bottle.
Maple barbecue sauce.
And this is $6.
Yeah, because you know how much work goes into this? History. So it started a long, long time ago. These are the tools that they use. So what they do is they drive these into the tree.
Oh, so they can get the juice
right
from the tree.
Yeah, and then it just drips out here into buckets.
Oh, okay.
That one, I see, so it comes up.
Yeah, you can see there's a hole right there.
These are the different, from years and years, the different size taps. Mm-hmm. This is with the original, they'd never heal up because they're so big.
Oh, okay.
This would be one. This is where taps were in the tree, and the tree just grew and they never healed. Today, we use this type of tap here on the blue line. And we'll tap the tree, within a year and a half, that hole will be all healed over, and it'll have a button actually coming out on it.
Oh, okay.
So they went a lot smaller, it's better in the tree.
Yeah.
These are from, well, just me and here, just tap these. We cut the trees down when they're dead. We got to split them to get different.
Thank you. Yeah. Very cool.
So like one of these?
Yeah.
To be in there?
So those trees won't heal because these are too big.
That hole is too big. Yeah.
So right now they're using the small tube.
Right.
It's better for the tree. Who found out actually, you know, this kind of tree?
I don't know.
Look at the history.
Eastern Native Americans. So the natives were doing it.
Okay. Smart.
So that was boiled down inside a hollow log.
Okay, so because they didn't put it on the fire, they didn't have metal containers.
So they have this.
They would
kind
have a log, and they would put stones in their fire to get it very hot, mm-hmm. and then put the stones in the log to boil off the water.
Smart.
Oh, here, look.
Yeah, warm days and cold nights make maple sap flow.
Yeah, so at night it goes up, and then during the day it comes down.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah, they fill that. That's full of sap.
Oh.
That's the sugar water, basically, that the trees use to live.
Oh.
And we're like pulling that out and collecting it.
This is our reverse osmosis station. Are you familiar with reverse osmosis? Well, when the sap comes in from the trees, the raw sap, it comes in and the sugar content in it is 1-1.5%, sometimes 2. Okay. So there's a ton of water.
Oh yeah.
So what they do, they drop it in this 4,000 gallon tank that sits outside this window, or outside here.
Yeah.
Then it is put through this reverse osmosis. Welcome to take them. It's informational. Maple syrup versus other sweeteners and things. You're welcome to taste them.
Just tastes like water.
Just water. Oh, let me try it.
Oh, you want to try it? Okay.
Yes, it's probably the sap.
This was supposed to be the raw.
Yeah, this simulates raw. Most people just taste water.
Yeah.
Because there's 1% sugar content.
Yeah.
You know?
Right?
A touch of sweetness in it.
This one.
That's the concentrate after they run it through the system.
Right, and sometimes even in this, a lot of people do taste
sweet. Yeah.
Yeah, some people don't taste anything.
There.
Morning.
Sweeter.
This is our reverse osmosis. Are you folks familiar?
Yeah, you can taste that.
Oh, can you?
This is water, right?
This is the pure water that's separated from.
Okay. That's just gonna be water.
I just drink some water.
Yeah, there's absolutely no minerals or vitamins in that at all.
That's good.
Distilled okay. Water. It's like a distilled water.
Step 3, evaporate.
How are you doing?
Good.
Today we're just boiling water to assimilate wood, because there's no sap out there.
A big old wood stove.
When we're running, I fill this firebox every 20 minutes. It'll be heat full. And if you look in
minutes.
Here, see them different things going up and down there?
Oh, yep.
They'd be full of sap. Them are all hollow.
Oh, okay.
They'd be right full of sap, and the fire would be shooting right back between them.
All right.
What it does, it feeds in the one in the back of the machine on the first one over there. It'll come forward, go over to the next one, go back. Back and forth, all the way until it reaches it over to this side of the machine.
All right.
And then it come out of there right here, and it goes into this front pan. And feed up through here, go over.
So this is like a second boil, basically.
Yeah, this is the finished boil.
Oh, okay.
Back here, I got 12 inches of water.
All right.
And then tubes. Here, I got 1.5 inches. So you really got to watch this, or you'll burn the pan.
Yeah.
But today, we just got water in. Usually, this is raw. I'm just making steam, basically, today. So
that's a demo, yeah.
Yeah, the demo. And I'll sit here and I'll check. But they call it bricks. But what it is the thickness. And we take it up to 55 bricks. So this thing will sit in a tube like this and it'll float up when it gets thick enough.
Okay.
When it's at 55, I'll run it off like this.
Oh.
Fill this up at the check-in. And when it goes below 55, I turn it off and let it go.
Say hi.
Electronic ones they put on here to do it automatically. But you gotta set it to this temperature and everything, the atmosphere every day.
Yeah.
And we've had them lock up and not open and burn
back
the pan.
Yeah, okay.
Burns the pan up, and so we just do it by hand.
Sometimes the old ways?
Yeah. Most guys do it with electronics. On a good day, in 10 hours, I can make 150 gallons of syrup, finished product, for you, if I have enough coming out of it.
On a good day.
We've only had two good days this year.
So. All right, so it's been a rough season.
Okay, there's step four.
Step
four. Right here.
Yeah, what's this whole setup?
So, we take everything about 99% of the way finished on the main evaporator. Everything in little batches over here, 15 okay. gallons at a time. So we'll put this on a turkey cooker. Then when it's done, we'll take it out of this and we'll put it through the filtering systems. The filter's the same type of filter they use in the beer and wine industry.
Okay.
The only real difference is we use a different cloth than they do. And there's 25 of these filters that go across, and we force it through all of them. When we actually take this filter out, it'll be caked in mud, like a quarter inch thick, all the way across the front. All
right.
So this is the sugar sand we're trying to get out of the syrup.
Okay.
And the sugar sand naturally just occurs in it. The more you cook the sap down, the more sugar sand kind of comes out of it.
All right.
It's brought up through the roots of the tree.
So that actually is sand, it's dirt.
Yeah, it's in.
Okay.
So it's sugar sand is what it's called.
I was gonna say, like, can we try that? But no, not if it's mud.
It's dirt.
Mud.
We tried making soap and stuff out of it in the past and thinking it would, you know, carry the scent to the maple, but it doesn't.
It's just mud at that
it's
point.
It's dirt.
Yeah.
Okay.
Could I interest you in a taste test or anything?
Absolutely.
Alright, get your spoon.
We'll start you off on the lower end.
You said this is what we had. I heard you say this is what we had
yep,
on the pancakes.
Yep, this is what would have been on the pancakes this morning.
Oh, this is called amber.
So this is amber.
Okay.
Yeah. It'll give you a kind of a starting point though for when you try the rest.
Sweet.
Yeah. Ooh, that's nice.
And then we'll go to the dark. And as it gets darker, it gets more of a maple flavor to it.
So what is the difference in, or how do you get the different types? Is it just the amount that's boiled off?
So typically the rule of thumb is earlier in the season, your tree is producing more sugar. So it'll be your textbook thing, 40 to 1, 40 gallons of sap to make 1 gallon of syrup.
Uh-huh.
But later in the season, your tree is producing less sugar and more water.
Okay.
So for the very dark, you could be doing 100 gallons of sap to make a gallon of syrup.
Okay.
And in turn, that's just a lot more time in the pans and stuff. You burn the sugars and cook them a little bit more.
So it's just more caramelized, really?
Well, more or less, content. But it's all cooked to the same. The sugar content across these is the same.
Oh.
Everything about them is the same. You actually check for when it's done by density tests.
Right, yeah, explain that.
So everything's taken to the same point. It's just the starting point that's different.
Okay.
So this takes a lot more cooking to get to the starting or finished point. Dark, or very dark.
That's what I'm used to.
That's the ticket?
That one, yeah.
Can I try it? Okay. The very dark, please? Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mm.
Now, can you compare that flavor to what we had at breakfast with the light?
I think that is very safe.
Yeah, no problem.
No, I tried this one. Did you try that? It's very dark.
Right, and it's got more of that
sweet.
You guys have pancakes?
Burned sugar.
Yeah.
This would have been what was on the pancakes.
Yeah. That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
You want to try it?
How does it go on the... Oh!
Yo!
Good?
I'm not going to move it, I don't think. Especially in the rain.
How good is that?
Oh my god. Spicy though.
No, it is spicy.
Because this is hot sauce. It's so
yeah,
spicy. It's good. You know what? Dave will love this sauce.
I'm gonna buy it. Yeah, I'm gonna buy it.
Thank you.
I mean, how can you not like it? Right?
Yeah.
That hot sauce though is bomb.
Okay, so shopping area.
Yep.
Right here.
Spend some money.
Obviously, you want to tap it. You don't want to tap it up like that because the sap's not going to flow out. You want to tap it at an angle so the sap flows down and out. So, Joel, hold because we'll let you tap a tree. Come on.
All right.
Okay, you used this before, right?
No.
Okay, well, just practice. You push okay. This, it goes slow. Push it, goes faster.
Oh.
You want to start out slow. If you don't start out slow, you start your hole.
Oh.
What will happen is the thing will just move around on you, okay? Just try it, practice, it won't. And usually when you hold it, you can push, take your other hand and push against like that.
Okay. I'll get out of the way.
All right. Here we go.
Hi, can you answer some questions?
Slow, start slow.
That's all right.
Start. All right.
There you go.
You gotta give it some pressure.
Ooh.
Ooh. Okay, got it. Push it, give it some push.
I'm pushing, I'm pushing.
You want that to bite in.
I'm pushing. Okay.
Oh, see how easy that is?
Okay, alright, got
now,
it.
To get it out, you gotta keep it running.
Oh. What?
All right.
You can bag it out,
okay.
Or you can throw it in reverse.
Oh, got it. That was fun.
Okay, now you've got your hole tapped.
Yeah.
Which one was it?
This one.
No.
This one.
Yeah, which one was it? That's what we've been going through all day.
I guess.
Good job. Excellent.
This is your drop line, they call it. Okay, this
yeah.
is where the sap's gonna flow out. Which one's your hole?
I think this is this one.
Okay. It's basically you take your hand and just push it in lightly. Just to hold it.
Okay.
Now, when you go to tap the tree, it's like one, two, and the third one will be a different sound. You won't get it with this tree.
Okay.
But the third one's definitely a different sound. And if you do it too hard, what happens? You get a split in the tree. You right-handed?
Yeah.
You want to stand on this side.
Sure.
As you think about it, you want to go like
okay.
that. You know about eye-hand coordination, right?
Yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Okay.
Three. Hi. Only okay. three.
One, two. The three is different? The third one?
She said you won't hear it in this.
Oh,
this tree doesn't make any difference.
Because it's not live.
No.
Okay.
You want to try putting it in right there?
Thank you.
You can have that as
yours too. Oh, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Make a necklace out of it. So
oh,
I don't
sure.
know.
Thank you.
Thank you. So now we're going to Emma's favorite part of this whole thing, the animals. They can't be too miserable. They're in a house, so and they're clothed. They're doing better than we are right now. We're the ones standing outside in the rain.
Yeah.
Right? And cows are dumb. What you doing?